My name is Kyri Baker. I'm an assistant professor in the Department of Civil, Environmental, and Architectural Engineering. I also have a courtesy appointment in the Department of Electrical, Computer, and Energy Engineering. I'm also a fellow of the Renewable and Sustainable Energy Institute, which is a joint institute between CU and the National Renewable Energy Lab. The long-term goal of my research is ultimately to impact people. I think I'm in a really unique position, having a background in power systems, but also having experience with my postdoc in buildings. And I've combined those two things to create a really unique research contribution that my students get excited about. Long-term, I hope to impact the larger scale goal of mitigating climate change by using my algorithms to operate grids more efficiently and to operate buildings more efficiently. The way the grid operates directly impacts what consumers pay for electricity, how many blackouts they experience, the quality of the power they receive in their homes. And so when we help the grid operate more efficiently, it will end up helping the consumer have a lower electricity bill and also less power outages and blackouts. So this is really a two-way path. Homeowners can help the grid, but the grid also has a responsibility for providing reliable power to homeowners. My group's research addresses questions like, how can people change the way they use energy, not just generate energy, in order to help accommodate renewables on the grid? There's a lot of interesting issues with that because renewable energy is highly stochastic. It's uncertain. We don't know as much, and it's less controllable than conventional power plants. So it takes both the demand and the supply sides to work together in order to integrate renewable energy. Having a national lab locally has really helped my group flourish. For example, the Systems Performance Laboratory at NREL offers a lot of smart appliances and smart home devices that can communicate with some of the algorithms that my group has developed. And having NREL, which is the only national lab in the U.S. that solely focuses on renewable energy, has really made CU a hub for renewable energy research. The local community in Boulder and in the broader Denver area has really stimulated innovation, especially with regards to both startups and research. And part of our new ARPA-E project, which is under the grid optimization competition, seeks to develop methods that might eventually turn into startups. So a lot of these optimization methods we're developing are tested on realistically sized grids that span the entire United States. And they're algorithms that help the grid operate more reliably and resiliently. So as more renewable energy is put onto the grid and integrated in with the existing power systems, we're having a lot more fluctuations in power. There's a lot more uncertainty. In some cases, this can actually increase electricity prices for consumers. And consumers, depending on what area of the country or even what region within a state they live in, their electricity prices could be triple that of other people in other regions. So pursuing economic equality in the way that we design and operate power grids is extremely important, not just minimizing carbon emissions, but also equalizing the benefit throughout consumers in the grid. One new method my group is looking at for helping power grids do this is by using machine learning to expedite solving the optimization problem that grid operators solve. So traditionally, if we're operating an extremely large grid with millions of consumers, millions of end users, the grid operators have to solve this really complicated optimization problem. It might take a very long time. So we're using machine learning to speed up finding the solution for that, which can help us integrate faster fluctuating energy sources like renewable energy.